go get some dinner. Just be good. This is ridiculous. What is going on? Where have I come to?
You to hear and see if you can hear how loud the sea is. Just listen. I have to go to sleep listening to this. It'll be fine, it'll be fine. I'll explain it, why I'm here and everything, in the morning if I survive. So it's still not the best weather outside, but look at that for a difference. Okay, so I'm actually going to explain why we're here now, or why I'm here, and I was just suddenly on a train and now I'm in Aberystwyth. My parents and I are going on a kind of a little tour from Port Merion in Wales down to the Pembrokeshire coast. I met them in Aberystwyth because I just finished work and they left before me, so that's why we came separately and now I'm here. I did manage to sleep last night despite all of the howling gale and rain. It was actually quite relaxing, so I'm okay with that, and I slept pretty well, even though I had to sleep like diagonal, like the wrong way on my bed because there was a lump in it the right way and I wasn't okay with that. Today we are going somewhere, I can't remember. You'll see when we get there. I'm really rubbish at what places are called, so normally just be like, okay mum, let's go. Tell me where we are when we get there. Okay, cool, thanks. So, when we get there, I'll tell you where we are. It's gonna be an interesting day, I think. It's not raining anymore, which is good, but it's not looking great. I would give you like a tour of the place we're staying in, but our stuff is literally everywhere. So, I'm just gonna like capture a few cute little bits because this is a really awesome, like, it's like a flat overlooking the sea and the harbour, so I'll show you. Out this way we've got the harbour view. I like that little boat down there, that's quite cool. We're going to go and find my friend's cafe called the Crimson Rhino. I know him from school, so I'm really excited to go and see him there. I have no idea where that is though, somewhere out there. So here is the living room. This is so cool. I love these. The little fisherman on. And some portholes. Pretty flowers in the lady's garden. And then if you come, and Welsh word that I don't know what it means, come and look out here. We are literally right on the sea. I would say that it's getting brighter, but you can't tell that on the camera. But seriously, it's getting brighter. It's going to be sunny today at some point. And then through here we've got the little kitchen, which is really cute. Dogs and teacups. Just when you thought the weather was getting better, I think it's getting worse. Thank you.
You were cold as the blood through your bones, and the light which led us from our chosen home. Well, I was lost.
And I found this massive hole which I desperately want to climb inside, so that's what I'm gonna do now. What's that?
Hmm?
What's that?
Finger.
Can I have one? Please.
Hmm.
Thank you. Other way up. Turn it the other way up. Other way. Other way. Just you twist.
You just twisted it.
From where I have been, I'll keep my eyes to serve, my hands to learn. Keep my eyes to serve, my hands to learn.
There was still light enough to pick up and carry. Yeah. So hunter-gatherers, those sort of
yeah.
people. Right. This end of the room now explains that all over the world, people came up with exactly that same
right.
idea.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So a country as remote as Tibet
yeah.
used yak hide to cover a basket.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. People in India and Vietnam used bamboo to make a basket.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that particular one was last used to take a family of people 500 miles across the South China Sea with
wow.
refugees to Hong Kong.
Yes.
The North American Indian.
Stand on the mud like this, and then you get in the middle with your foot, because if you don't get in the middle, you fall off. I learned that. And then you sit in it like this, and you put your feet on the end here, and then you wiggle this around like this, and then suddenly, when you catch your salmon, you have to hit it with a stick and do all of these things at once. I missed it. Good. Salmon caught. Now we have to get to shore, get out, leave your oar over here, you don't need that anymore, and then carry this. How heavy is it? First, you have to put your salmon up there, otherwise, it will fall out of the coracle. This is well heavy. And I lost my stick.
Here. I'm too small, you're too tall, this is no good. We won't be catching any fish today. We might catch fish, but then we have to leave them there.
Yeah, so both hands are underneath.
Yeah. Oh. Well, I think they're all carrying it slightly different, to be honest with you. Right, so in case you are now very, very confused, which I'm sure you are, a coracle is a small circular boat made out of hazel, another type of tree, and animal hide or cloth coated in this like sticky black stuff. And it was originally used for fishing and for transport and lots of things like that. And this place in Wales, they have a lot of them. I mean, this is the National Coracle Centre, so it is where all of the coracles are if you wanted to see any of them. And actually, it was really cool. It's really interesting to see all like the men who built them and used them and the way they used them, and have a go with one, which proved that I am way too small, and if I ever build a coracle, I need to build a tiny coracle because I am not tall enough or big enough in any way for this. We're now at the mill part of it, so I'll show you around that. It's an Eleanor-sized coracle. Okay. I keep forgetting where we're going.